Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now, if you've watched my videos or read my articles, you've probably heard me say over and over again that genetics aside, one of the primary reasons you look and feel the way you do is because of your hormones. And one of the most powerful hormones in your body is insulin, which is released by the pancreas to help manage and lower blood sugar levels or high blood sugar levels. And I bring this up because someone asked me, is it true that Alzheimer's disease is now classified as type 3 diabetes? Now, to me, this is a really important topic because first, my grandmother had Alzheimer's, and thus it's a very personal topic for me, and thus it's in my family history. Also, as we age, we all start to lose brain function, and yes, high blood sugar is linked to memory and dementia. And finally, we have the highest percentage of prediabetes and diabetes ever in history at the moment, and it's just getting worse each and every year. And the point is that most people think diabetes or high blood sugar affects only their physical body, right? You gain weight, you have eyesight problems, you have fatigue and memory loss, or you have impotence, you have blood flow problems, and so forth. However, it also affects your brain and cognition, which is why I want to do today's topic. Now, some new research studies have proposed that Alzheimer's disease might also be classified as a specific type of diabetes called type 3 diabetes. And just a quick lesson or overview, type 1 diabetes is more genetic-based. It's an autoimmune disease where you need to take insulin for the rest of your life. Type 2 diabetes, this is the one most people are familiar with. It's more lifestyle related, which can be controlled with diet, pills, and or insulin injections. The good news is that it is reversible, while type 1 is not. So now comes type 3 diabetes for Alzheimer's, which is currently not widely accepted yet by everyone, right? Needless to say, it's a more specific form of diabetes for the brain and dementia and memory loss, and yes, Alzheimer's disease. Now, the good news about all this is that like type 2 diabetes, you know, type 3 diabetes can very well be avoided, or the process can definitely be slowed down tremendously or even reversed specifically if you know that it's part of your history. So if you are concerned about your memory, or you have a potential family history of high blood sugar or diabetes or Alzheimer's or similar issues like I do, there is hope. However, I'm not going to repeat myself in today's video because I did a more detailed video about this topic in the past, the causes, and of course, the natural solutions. And the direct link to that video is found below in the description area here. So while it's fresh on your mind, click that link, go watch the important video about high blood sugar and Alzheimer's disease. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.